Hey, what's going on YouTube? It's Rack718 back with another video. And actually, it's a comic book haul, $20, $30, $40 challenge entry. So a quick shout out to Drahcir Comics and Things and Kingdom Comics. I have to be honest, Drahcir, when I watched your challenge video, I kind of laughed. Like, what the heck? I'm not going to do that. You're making me spend $20, $30. What the heck are you doing? But, and don't take it the wrong way. I was just talking to myself, just laughing in my head. Like, what? But, it worked out. It worked out. So you'll see what I mean when as I go off my video. But, definitely a quick shout out to you. Really, really cool idea. I don't think, you know what, today was crazy. I don't think I did this ever in my life. Okay, it worked out. Like I said, I've been planning this day for like months and months. I told myself I was going to go to Second and Charles and you know, kind of spend the day out there. Boy, the day turned out to be 6-7 hours, man. I had breakfast this morning, and my LCS called me, a different LCS called me and said, hey, we got your Mighty Marvel Venomized, because they didn't come in on Wednesday, so I picked them up today when my LCS called me, picked up my, you know, 3, 4, 9.8 copies. And I was like, okay, you know, the Second and Charles, they're only 5 minutes away from my house. I mean, I could probably walk there. They're 5 minutes away. They're real close. And I spent, you know, 6+ hours, man. I don't know if I'll ever do that again. It must have been over 30 long boxes, man. But like I said, I told myself I was going to do this. I wanted to do it, you know, reading blogs and, you know, online articles and watching YouTube videos. You know, a lot of people do this kind of stuff. So it was fun. I mean, met this guy named James. He works there. I guess he's the what do you call it, the curator? He handles all the comic books in the store, and he showed me some pictures on his phone. He has over 50 long boxes at his house, so quick shout out to James. He doesn't have a YouTube channel, that's the first thing I asked, but you know, he does watch gaming videos and stuff. So today, all this came up. I have 15 comic books. All came out to be about $31. At checkout, I realized I had $12 credit at the Second and Charles. I forgot I had, you know, I'd sold some games and some other stuff there, electronics. So I had about $12 credit. And then James, the employee I told you about, you know, we talked all day. I basically talked throughout his shift. I mean, he was kind of reorganizing the shelves and stuff. And he gave me a $5 coupon, so that's $17 credit right there, basically, minus the $31 I spent. So I guess total about $14 cash at checkout. So again, I didn't have a list, I didn't have a piece of paper. I was just going off of my head, you know, memories and visualization and what I could remember from certain YouTube videos. I text Doom, quick shout out to Doom. Thank you, Doom143. Thank you for responding and seeming, I felt like you was right next to me. So, so yeah, this is what I got. 15 books. Howard the Duck, number one. This cover, like, you know, I remember this cover. I didn't know what was about it. And I don't think this is the cover to get, but I got it anyway. This is the first appearance of Gwenpool, came out in 2016. So I think the cover to get, I think the Gwenpool appearance to get is the 1/25 limb variant, I believe is the more desirable book, but I still wanted to add this to my collection, so I'm happy to get this, 99¢. So I couldn't turn it down. The next comic I get was just for the cover, man. I mean, I don't think it's worth anything, and I got it for $1. New Mutants 28. I mean, that looks like magic right there, and just the cover with the, you know, with the aliens or whatever. But it's Volume 4, New Mutants 28. It's the unfinished business storyline, so, you know, it's about a $1 book anyway. So I'm gonna definitely put this in my collection. And all these books are near men. I mean, all these books, maybe the exception of one, and I'll show you that. All these are near men. All the books I'm about to show you, they're probably going to go to my raw collection. I mean, I don't think I'm going to send these off to CGC or for grading. But, I mean, I'm definitely want to build my raw collection. This is Star Trek number one. Came out in 1980. I mean, this is a clean copy. Got this for a dollar. So, just, you know, goes with my Star Wars number one. Thought I'd get a Star Trek number one for a dollar. This is pretty cool. Daredevil 58. Again, this cover, I don't know what was up, but the cover stood out to me when I saw it. Got this for 95 cents, actually. And this is the first modern night nurse, Dr. Claire Temple. This came out in 2004. So, again, just a beautiful copy. No tick marks. Well, there's some marks, but they're pressable. They're not color breaking. But again, going to my raw collection. I didn't have a chance to rebag and reboard these. I didn't have a chance to put microchamber in my comics, which I normally do. On all my raw books, I put microchamber in the front and back. But yeah, I just want to show it to you as is. So Daredevil 58, pretty cool comic. I like it. Glad to pick that up. Now this one, again, I didn't know the significance, and the funny thing is I forgot to charge my phone last night, so, you know, I kept my phone right on the counter while I was looking at the comics, and, you know, before I know it, I was at 1%, so I was like, man, I can't even use my phone anymore, but anyway, this is the Agents number 6, and, this came out in 2003, and this supposedly is the first Walking Dead appearance. There's like a preview story in here. So, I mean, this, what I've seen is like a $20, $30 book, and I got it for a dollar, so that's pretty cool. But again, this is probably going to my raw collection. I'm not trying to flip these, to be honest with you. I just want to keep, well, actually, there's one I'll probably flip, and I'll show you guys. But yeah, this is pretty cool. I can't wait to open it and rebag it and kind of check out the storyline inside. The Walking Dead first preview, first appearance in this comic. And I remember somebody showed that in their comic book or in their YouTube video, excuse me. So this one, man, this store, ladies and gentlemen, if you have a Second and Charles near you, please go to it. I mean, it's a sacrifice to spend 4, 5, 6 hours like I did. And, you know, I went there, what, 10, 11 o'clock. I didn't leave until 8 o'clock at night. I didn't drink, eat lunch, eat dinner. Man, I'm starving. But if you have one, I mean, definitely check it out. I mean, they had a lot of comics. They had a lot of Grendel. You know, they didn't have the one I was looking for. They had a lot of Sandman. I thought I got lucky and got that Sandman 75, I think I texted Doom, but it wasn't the second print, so I was like, oh well. They had a lot of Carnage, they had a lot of Hawaiian Dick comics, I guess every store has that. And they had a lot of Alpha Flight, Ultimate X, but they didn't have the blonde hair Wolverine, but they had some other issues, Walking Dead. And they had a lot of this. Rick and Morty, they didn't have number one, the one I was looking for, number one, but they had this number one, which is a variant, came out in 2015, and this was limited to 1,250. This is the Books a Million edition, and this is like a $50 book. I was like, holy smoke. So I heard of this title, I know about it, I heard about it, but I was looking for the other number one issue. But it seems this is a pretty good comic right here, and I got this for 95 cents. So I was very surprised to see this. And they had other issues of this too. They had Rick and Morty like up to 20 or 25 or something. So I was very surprised to see this comic. This is really, really a cool find. I mean, it's probably a very fine near mint. I mean, there's about 3-4 color breaking tick marks there. But I mean, this is a pretty cool find right here, so that's pretty cool. Got this for $1.50. Wolverine and the X-Men number 28. This is the variant edition. This came out in 2013. It's the 1-in-20 McLean variant. So, you know, I just like the cover. You know, I'm not trying to grade it or flip or anything. I just like the cover. It's pretty cool, the title. This is pretty cool. I was happy to get this for 95 cents. Spider-Man Deadpool number 8. This came out in 2016. Was the first appearance of Itsy Bitsy. So I've seen this on a couple of videos and glad to pick this up. So this is pretty cool. Can't wait to re-bag and board that. I can look inside. This is Carnage number 3. They had a lot of Carnage, man. This is Carnage number 3 for 95 cents. Pick this up. This is the variant. I was really hoping to get the poultry variant and the a couple of the number 1, I guess, but I couldn't find those. But I did find this Carnage number 3. This is the 1-in-20 variant, Marvel 92 Diodato variant. So this is pretty cool. 95 cent pickup. That cover is awesome, man. And it came with a pretty cool Mylar bag. These Mylites 2, I guess you call it. That's pretty sharp. Now this is cool, man. When I saw this, this is Carnage number 4 variant. This is the 1-in-10 variant, Deadpool Poke variant. This came out in 2016, and it's the Tom Randy cover. So I thought that was cool. For 95 cents, picked it up. Really cool. Really cool Carnage variant right there. And the rest, and actually I looked online, this is probably like a $20 book right here. I was surprised to see that. And then the Carnage before that is another $20 book, I think. $10-$20 book. So, you know, we'll see how that goes. In the last couple comics, I've never seen these. I've never seen these comics before. Age of Ultron, Book of Three. Book 3, Issue 3, Age of Ultron, number 3. Number 4. Number 5. Number 7. And number 8. And they had multiple copies of this series here. I'm still missing, issue 1 and 2, and then 9 and 10, I guess. But somebody's selling 1 through 10 online for like $140. So, you know, these were, $2-3 right here. But I never heard of this series. These are variant editions. These are the 1-in-25 variant covers by Rocky Kim. Never heard of that artist, but I just thought these were cool. I mean, I'm definitely going to be on a hunt for the missing issues in the series, but these are all near mint. They had multiple copies. I kind of went through all of them, opened it up, and kind of picked the best ones. I mean, these could, you know, these are definitely potential 9.6, 9.8 comic books right here. But I just thought these were pretty cool. I never heard of them. Definitely add that to my raw collection. And thought that was cool. So, yeah, that's what I picked up. Hope you, that was fun. That was fun to say the least. I'm not sure if I'll do that again. But I did make a relationship. I did make a relationship with a comic book guy that worked in a store. And he said to come back next Tuesday to get first dibs on the comics he's going to put on the shelf. So that's pretty cool. Oh, and that reminds me, you know, lesson learned right here, ladies and gentlemen. Lesson learned. I text this to Doom so he knows what I'm about to say. But, man, I missed out today. You know, I got there like 10, 11. And I'm going through the long boxes. They had shelves, and then they had long boxes on the floor. So they had really long, the shelves were like a long box. And I was probably like on the third one, and you know, they had like 20 on one side and then 20 on the other side. So, and then I saw James, but I didn't know James at the time. I just saw an employee come in, and he looked like he was retaping the comic books and was about to put some new comics on the shelf. But something told me inside of me to go see him. Go see what he's about to put in the shelf. Go see what he's about to do. Excuse me. And I didn't do it. The only thing on my mind was to get through those long hauls, those boxes that I wanted to get through. And next thing you know, this older gentleman comes out of nowhere and says, "Oh, can I see what you got?" And I was like, "Oh man, don't tell me he's about to find something." He found that Granoff Venom. What was that? Amazing Spider-Man 569, I think it is. The Granoff variant for $1. He found that Amazing Spider-Man, was it 529? The Iron Man suit, the Iron Spider suit for $1. And then he found that Ross variant. I think the lizard is on the cover, his head. The lizard or vulture or the green. Yeah, he got that for $1. He said he's going to get it so Ross can sign it. Man. Lesson learned, if you see an employee with new stock, stop what you're doing and go see what he has before he puts it on his shelf. Man, if I would have stopped what I was doing and went to see him, I would have had that Venom. I mean, I already have a 9.8, the Granoff Venom, and I already have a 9.8 in the spider suit, but to have a raw copy, that would have been real cool. So anyway, lesson learned. Hope you like this story. Hope you like these this video. Definitely like and subscribe, ladies and gentlemen, if you do. Again, quick shout out to Drahcir Comics and Things and Kingdom Comics. Great contest or challenge entry, excuse me. Great challenge entry. Again, everything added up to $31 plus minus $17 because of the credit. And I paid $14 for this haul, basically. All right. Take care, guys, and as usual, collect what you want to collect, but please take care of those comics. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.